Ladies and gentlemen, Billy Connolly.
Thank you. God bless you. You're a wonderful audience.
I like all that stuff. I like going to the country and western shows in here and say, thank you very much, you're a beautiful audience, and I think I love you. And it's really nice to be back here in, oh Christ, where are we? Yeah, Scotland or something. But this is a song about swearing. Now, ooh! Ooh, we got little sisters of the poor in the night, aren't we? Father Murphy fainting at the back. This is a song about swearing. Now, as you know, swearing is nasty. It's a real nasty. Everybody hates it and everybody does it for some obscure reason. I bet the Pope swears. Yeah, swears in Latin, dead sneaky. But nobody's going to tell me that when the moderator of the General Assembly of the Church of Scotland drops that big Bible, he says, jings. No way. But you know, swearing affects, as I say, almost everybody swears. I certainly do. But sometimes I get him, oh, do I hear one? Will I say a wee sweary? I'll do it after, I'm shy. No, really. I used to get embarrassed by people swearing if I was with a wee bit of stuff. Or sometimes even if I was with my wife or that. Or anybody you like a lot, you're sitting in a bus and there's some idiot at the back steaming going, you're a fun person. Hey, you're a fun person. You're a fun person. Right, so George Square's the place for the great swearers and the great drunks. You got all these rubber men waiting in buses. What's up, baby? Hey, pal, eh? They walk like puppets, won't they? You ever notice them puppets in the telly? They always look as if they're steaming. You see the wee man at the bus stop in George Square, walking with one leg like that. Wondering how he's knackered, no getting anywhere. He's got a fish supper in the left hand, looks as if it weighs about 200 weight. It's a way of doing it at his knee. He's trying to stare out the chip in his right hand. He's a bottle of beer in the left-hand jacket pocket and a half bottle on the inside in the left. So his jacket's all weighed down at one side like that. Can hardly walk, he keeps walking in circles. Annoying everybody at the bus stop, asking them if they're all right. Yeah, they? Huh? Hey, how are you? Are you no tongue to me, pa? You think I'm a shite or something? See, they have really delicate ways of putting things. You think I'm a shite, I think you're a poof. High heels and your hair's dyed, you must be a poof. Huh? And he manages to scramble onto the bus, slides up the stair, and he's sick over somebody's wee dug.
Don't mind eating that.
It's
Jimmy, can you get a hairy fish? Oh, this is a fish supper, look at that.
And he turns around and addresses the whole top deck of the bus. Shut up. Is it a song, you said, one? No! He manages to wobble his way up and find another drunk. So he sits down and talks to him. Well, they don't really talk to each other. They sit and swear at each other for a wee while. You know, to make it really convenient, they drop all the other words and just swear for a while. So, yeah, pleasure. And the other guy's that drunk, he sounds as if he's drooning. Anyway, then he see, looks at his watch and decides it's time to be sick. I saw an incident in the last bus to Drumchapel one night, which will stay with me for as long as I live. There was two guys in that bus, both lunatics. One had been a boxer, and he was going... Every time a conductor rang a bell, he got up and battered somebody. Then he'd ring the bell to stop me, he'd sit down. Fan himself doing ding ding, hello, what? Somebody else get a message. My next to him was his halfwit, steaming out of the brain. The bunnet went backwards. He's being sick, and there was a guy sitting directly in front of him with a duffel coat on. The hood hanging over the back of the seat. And this guy's been sick. Now, he's not been sick into the hood of the duffel coat, but the guy in front thinks he is, because he's hanging on to the hood, because he thinks it's the back of the seat. And every time he bends down to his seat, he goes, and the guy shoots back in his seat. He's sitting there, feeling really grateful that he brought an umbrella as it starts to rain. Oh, but you see, swearing, as I told you earlier, I swear, sure, but I'm sneaky about it. I invented my own swear words that I can say in front of my wains, my childers, my offspring. Yeah, it's not nice to swear in front of your kids, because they take it to school and everybody knows it was you that started it. So I invented my own words. BASA is a good one. BASA. That comes in quite handy. Yeah, you BASA, get out of there! And there's another very good one. GETIFU, Getifa. That comes in very handy, that one. Especially if you string it with BASA. Getifa, you BASA! You can do it with complete confidence. Yeah, BASA, get fire there! It really sounds quite convincing. But it's not necessarily swearing. If you invented it, you can invent a meaning for yourself. You can change the meaning every day if you like. It can mean a lovely bunch of little pink daisies. Say, oh, look at a wee getty for you, BASA. See, it's entirely up to you. But the song is about a guy called Kenneth Tynan, who swore on television a long, long time ago. He said, The country was up in arms, the newspapers were flabbergasted that somebody had dared to swear on the telly. Mary Whitehouse nearly fainted. Mind you, I wouldn't be too cheery if my name rhymed with toilet. But look, this... He's trying to explain it. He's going, White House Lavi, it doesn't work. Right.
No, it doesn't work with clergy either. I don't get it.
But I thought it was a good thing. I really did. Because he sort of opened the floodgates to everybody, and plays became more realistic after that. They're saying, what? Yeah, I'll sort you out. Whereas the way they were before that, they were all saying, take that, you bounder, biff. You scoundrel, I'll box your ears. Biff, take that. Look away, Martha, scud. Yes, you gave Philip everything, didn't you, father? Well, you'll pay for it now. Don't be a fool. Look out behind you. I wouldn't fall for that old... Ah! So, it was a load of nonsense, wasn't it? But anywho, what he did was open the floodgates to everybody, and they could have a wee swear every now and again. But as I say, you have to draw the line somewhere. Like Jack and Nori. I mean, can you imagine?
Once a teddy bear found a little piece of chocolate. Oh,
look at that!
You see? It doesn't work. It's not nice, is it? Or you get Andy Pandy coming out of his box.
Where's that Libby Lou? Get her into this hamper. 15 years I've been in there myself, I'm gone blind!
There was a young man from the BBC. His name was Ken Tynan, and I'm sure you'll agree. He dropped a real clanger that night when we heard him using a 1-2-3-4-letter word. A four-letter word, a four-letter word. To ban it would be a shame. It's honest, it's earthy, it ought to be heard. That wonderful 1-2-3-4-letter word.
That was a chorus.
It's banded around by the kids for a lark. It's put into practice as soon as it's dark. It's done every night by the rich and the poor. To do it is worse than to say it, I'm sure. A four-letter word, a four-letter word. To ban it would be a shame. Get in there, it's honest, it's healthy, that's the stuff. Sing up that wonderful...
Oh, Christ, the dinner.
I don't believe it.
What a given.
It shouldn't be said in polite company when aged old ladies are sipping their tea. But if those ladies' pasts were revealed, sure as hell, they've not only said it, they've done it as well. A four-letter word, a four-letter word. To ban it would be a shame, that's the game. It's honest, it's earthy, but on. Wonderful. Four-letter word.
Well done. I know what it is. That's the band for the pavilion. The place is empty. They've come out for a wee seat. Have you seen the Tuchters get in there? Oh, I like watching your queue versus theirs. Your queue's going, we are the Christians. And their queue's going, la 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 la. Aye, when they're taking their time about getting in, they put the swords down and have a wee dance. Well, they're great, them Tuchters. They all bring in the recordings, you know, and join in up in the balcony. Oh, oh. The half bottle at the feet. Allah! Have you seen them? They come from Stornoway in buses and all that. You can spot them. They're all walking about like that. Is that a skyscraper? No, that's a pillar box. And a skyscraper in the road there. But some weeks ago, I heard this song, and this is a song I'm about to do, and I couldn't keep my hands off it. Our little dog is 6 years old, and he's smart as any damn kid. But when you mention the VET, he damn near flips his lid. Words like S-H-O-T shot or W-O-R-M worm, these are words that make him S-Q-U-I-R-M squirm. His Q-U-A-R-A-N-T-I-N-E starts today, 'cause he bit the VET and then he ran away. It caused me and my wife to have a big fight, and then both of them bit me. And that's why I am gonna get a D-I-V-O-R-C-E. Thank you. She shouted, "Get him, Rover!" And he jumped over and bit my L-E-G. She sank her teeth in my B-U-M and called me a Well, I'm telling you, that was my cue to get O-F-F-ski. And I'm going down to the town tonight to get a new B-I-R-D. Oh yes, a Q-U-A-R-A-N-T-I-N-E starts today. Both my wife and my wee scabby dog will soon be hauled away. That's why I spell out all of these words, so as my dog can't hear. Oh, I must admit, that dog is acting Q-U-E-R queer. Oh yes, I must admit, my dog is acting Q-U-E-R queer. What have you been drinking anyway, Kamikaze? You've been in the Sari heat tonight. I can smell your breath from here. She shouted at me 3 years ago at a concert. I know that blouse anywhere. Look. This. Aye, that's again. For Christ's sake, throw a net at her, will you? Aye. What's up? Send Igor up the back, will you? What's that? I can't really hear much of what you're saying. Are you chuchters? Yeah. Ah, I thought so. The pigtails are a dead giveaway, aren't they? Aye, I saw you outside taking a photo of your bus. Is that to take him and Sarah Wayne's, aye? Look. A hoose with wheels. Oh, you been into that draft porridge? It's enough of sin, really. You should feel sorry for them, you know. They used to eat each other. I'm not kidding. They used to get torn right into each other. That's how they call them chuchters. It's chuck tough, you know. You all right? Thank God I only bite my nails. Ach, well, it's a sin, really. They're more to be pitied than scolded, I can assure you. Once again. Right, you still at it, aye. Well, see, please keep it up, because the reason I'm talking to you all the time is so as a bouncer knows where you are. You've got one sentence left and you're out in your arse. Make it a good one. Aye. Well, this next song's about the Territorial Army. I used to be in the Terries. That's the truth. I couldn't help it. I was a wee boy with acne, and I thought it sounded like a good idea. I thought it would make me look like Joe the superhero. Action Man. Was all spots, the red berry. But we used to go on exercises with the Territorials, up to a place near Dundee, with all sorts of fields and woods and things. We had wee battles up there with other regiments. Oh, shooting blanks at each other. For all the good it was doing, it'd be as well to give you a squib and let you leave your rifle in the house, you know? We're running about with red berries and that, think you're a hero. Amazing, we're all running into battle, going... Then you discover a guy running beside you with an armband and it says, umpire. And he goes, dead! I say, what? Dead? No chance! Dead! Piss off! I want to stay with my pals! The grass is soaking! Dead. What does that make you? Here's a wee Terry song. I am a weekend soldier, and the world is scared of me. I've fought a million battles and I'm always home in time for tea. When I was but a sporty youth and tired of being ignored, I suddenly said to myself, now why are you so bored? I wanted some adventure, some muscles and some power. So I went to my local territorials and joined within the hour. Oh yes, I am a weekend soldier and the world is scared of me. I fought a million battles and I'm always home in time for tea. Well, I've been in the Terries for a wee while now, and I must say it isn't all that bad. Oh, when I put my red berry on, I feel like Alan Ladd. Oh, my camouflage smock fits me perfectly, but the trousers could be improved. I have to take three steps or more before they even start to move. Oh, yes, I am a weekend soldier, and the world is scared of me. I fought a million battles and I'm always home in time for tea. So watch out all you baddies, or I'll be on you in a trice. Or this is the way to see the world, boys. We've been to Edinburgh twice. Aye, and all you left-wing radicals, don't give us any of your cheek. And have the revolution on a Saturday, 'cause I have to work through the week. Oh yes, I am a weekend soldier, and the world is scared of me. I fought a million battles and I'm always home in time for tea.
Thanks a lot. Thanks a lot.
Thanks. Well, the more serious the army tries to get about the recruiting films, the funnier they become. Have you seen the latest one with a tank in the forest? That cracks me up completely. It's been on television a couple of times. The tank trundles through the forest, and the lid opens, and the head comes out.
Hello. My name's Bob and I'm a bone leader.
This guy's got the lot, the bolt through the neck and a zip up the back of the head.
Couple of gear. Yeah, I've been in the army only 3 years now. I make £40 a week all found, and I keep the lot because I'm a selfish bastard, right? That's my mate, Harry, over there. Hello, Harry.
Hello.
Harry's doing his hunkers with a frying pan with two eggs in it. There's five of them, he's got two eggs, right?
Hello, my name's Harry, yeah. I've been in the army now for about 3 years, yeah. I'll make £40 a week as well. You can get thousands and thousands of Smarties for £40.
That's my mate, Charlie, over there. Here's Charlie. Charlie's a real halfwit. He's in the middle of a firm going, brook, chick, dook, woohoo. Brook, dook, dook, dook. The farmer's going, what? They shoot back to the woods again. The guy with the eggs must be a real crawler. He's nipped up and given them to the barn leader. He scoffed a lot. Nobody said anything. They're all half shaved up against trees and all that. All half lathered. He says, right, lads, here we go. And they all pile back in, starving, half shaved. In a way, and then the big voice comes on. Will you be happy going to your work tomorrow? You're bloody right I will, sure. Oh, no me, pal. When they're talking about their computers, they don't talk about shooty gunnies. There's some wee guy from Banff or something says, oh, that sounds good to me. Free clays and a shot of your computer, that's okay, that. And money day, oh goody. I'll let you play with a real gun, no hard me back. The next thing he knows, he's battering down the Shankill Road with a gun in his hand. The best laxative known to man. Well, the last song before we end this spot or blemish, it's a country song, so without any further ado, me and the band's going to get wired right in. It's called Coat of Many Colours. I learned it from a... Oh, to hell where I learned it. It's called Coat of Many Colours. Probably bore the arse off you anyway. Here you go. Back through the years I go wandering again, back through the seasons of my youth. I recall a box of rags someone gave us, and the way my mama put those rags to use. There were rags of many colours, some of them were small, and I didn't have a coat. It was late on in the fall. My mama sewed the rags together. She sewed every piece with love. She made my coat of many colors. I was so proud of. As she sewed, she told a story in the Bible she had read about a coat of many colors. Joseph wore it then, she said. She hoped the coat would bring me good luck and happiness. I was really proud to wear it. Mama sewed the very best. My coat of many colors that my mama made for me, made of only rags, but I wore it so proudly. Though we
much money. I was rich as I could be, and my coat of many colours my mama made for me. So with patches on my breeches, holes in both of my shoes, in my coat of many colours, I started out to school. I could hear the children laughing, all making fun of me, in my coat of many colours my mama made for me. Well, I didn't mind the laughing, 'cause I knew that I was rich, and I told them of the love my mama sewed in every stitch. And I told them all the story mama told me while she sewed, and my coat of many colours worth more than all their gold. But they didn't understand, though I tried to make them see. You are only poor, only if you choose to be. Though we didn't have much money, I was rich as I could be, in my coat of many colours my mama made for me. In my coat of many colours my mama made for me.
Thank you very much indeed. Thank you.
If it wasn't for your wellies, where would you be? You'd be in the hospital or infirmary, for you would have a dose of the flu or even blue to see. If you didn't have your feet in your wellies, oh wellies, they are wonderful, oh wellies, they are swell, 'cause they keep out the water and they keep in the smell. And when you're sitting in a room, you can always tell when some bugger takes off his wellies. If it wasn't for your wellies, where would you be? You'd be a sing or in for sing, 'cause you would have a sing, sing, sing. So you better get your feet in your way. Ah! If it wasn't for your wellies, where would you be? Say, you'd be in the hospital, for you would have a dose of the flu. If you didn't, any yada. Oh, hey, wait a minute, we'll do a Glenn Daly ending. In a yada way. As we progress this evening, I will talk of many things. Some of them wholesome, some of them offensive. I don't think they're offensive. I talk a lot about odd subjects like willies and bums, jobbies, lavies. I don't care. Don't you start caring. Don't get embarrassed, please. You're in the dark, forget about it. Because I don't get embarrassed. There's no sense you sitting blushing yourself. Like, I talk about willies because they're funny objects. Willies! Willies are funny. You know, people get all funny about willies and they go, hey doctor, it's my, I forget the right name for it now. They never say, I've got a terrible sore willy this morning. See, oh, my leg. Especially having been to infant school, primary school, where everybody's telling lies to each other. You get all mixed up and you don't know what the truth is. People say, I'm telling you this and I'm no kidding. That's when you know it's a lie. This is no kidding. I know a guy and this is no kidding. He's got a huge big willy. That's nice.
You go like that, weren't bigging like that, would you? See, you're through life thinking you're a bit imperfect. I'm telling you, I know another guy, and this is naked. It's a big, huge wally. He takes a boot and a barra. So reality goes out the window.
Well, I wish I had one of these big, big willies. Where'd I pee? Heard of a willy there. Is that with me? Maybe it's because I'm a Catholic or something.
That's why you cover it up when they're having a pee, you're not embarrassed, right? I'll tell you a trick I used to do. It works very effectively. When you're in the public toilet and you're doing a pee and you're finished, instead of just sort of shakety-shake and put it away, kid on, you're giving it a shake and slap your hand on the side of the urinal. Smack! Smack! You walk out the place like a giant. See, that takes me to public toilets now. I think they're funny. I don't just mention them because they're dirty. I genuinely think it's funny. Like these public urinals, or urinals, or however the hell you pronounce it. You're not standing in a line having a wetty. You don't want to look round in case there's somebody smiling at you.
You start speaking like that, yes, I'm just in for a pee, understand?
And then you're standing there watching the tiles. Or the bricks, you know. Because once you've read Shanks Barhead, that's your lot. Very boring. Sometimes you manage to get the VD notice right in front of you. That keeps you going for a good 3 minutes. Oh, there's a black street. Oh, I see, I am. Special clinic. Oh, I see, I am. Then you start to get scared as you get to the symptoms. A quick inspection. As you remember, that wee mark on it was when you caught it in your zip last week. Then you get the guys who haunt the public toilets. The Willy Watcher. What are you looking at? He's hanging over your wee cubicle like a coo looking at a dyke. Get out of here, what's that? I was going to get F off tattooed in mine. Too many letters, you know? But look, this... This is a wee song. It's maybe you remember yourself at school. And you're sitting, you hate your teachers. Now, I hated all my primary school teachers. Detested them, well, most of them, you know. You used to sit in your seat and say, wait till I leave school. I'm coming back here and you're getting it. I'm going to go, yeah, they'll never know me. I'll have a bailer suit and a bonnet. Oh, these thugs and those janitors. Oh, how I wanted to kill a few of them. Oh, animals.
Oh, it's nothing to do with me, but I saw them playing football and breaking the window. If you ask me, the man's a thug.
Five of us.
Good for nothing, he'll come to nothing.
There you were. Oh, snotters and trousers that were too big. Condemned for life, according to the Janny. Oh, how I wanted to murder them. Far as I can remember, half of them were bent anyway. Hello.
Putting bandages in your knees. There, there. See, no, there, there. A trail of Smarties into the boiler room. There's a song about Jannies and how you never really get round to beating up your teachers. When I was wee, I used to have a nightmare every night. I woke up screaming just before the monster took a bite. He wore a blue serge outfit with buttons shiny and bright. I lived in terror, oh the Janny, aye the Janny. He nearly drove me mad. He shot me to the teachers any time that I was bad. I wish that he'd retire or die or move to Gamgad. My heart's near broke with the Janny. Nothing against Gamgad, I couldn't think of anything else to rhyme. I wouldn't wish a Janny on you if you live in Gamgad. I mean, one summer evening I was playing on the street. A simple game of football with my sannies on my feet. I hit the ball, I stoter, and it soared away a treat. The last thing on my mind was the Janny. But I don't look for trouble, and I seem to get my share. The ball went sailing skyward, slowly curving in the air. The last thing I remember, there was plate glass everywhere. And guess who saw me? The Janny. Oh, the Janny, aye, the Janny. He nearly drove me mad. Shot me to the teachers any time that I was bad. I wish that he'd retire or die or move to Gamgad. My heart's near broke with the Janny. First thing on Monday morning, I was sent for by the head. And he hit me with his leather belt till I wished that I was dead. I swore I'd get the Janny and choke him in his bed. I was gonna murder the Janny. Well, 9 years later, I left school and I got myself a job. It felt $1 million just to have a couple of bob. I was out the road of the traffic, didn't need to steal or rob. And I've yet to see a shipyard with a Janny. Oh, the Janny, aye, the Janny. He nearly drove me mad. Shopped me to the teachers any time that I was bad. I wish that he'd retire or die or move to Gamgad. My heart's near broke with the Janny. One night on my way home from work, I nipped in for a pint. Something glistened in the corner of my eye, just out of sight. I saw it was the Janny. I prepared myself to fight. I was gonna murder the Janny. Well, the next thing I remember, he was standing next to me. He wasn't such a big bloke, only 5'2" or 5'3". If I'd laid a hand upon him, my mates would have murdered me. A poor wee soul was the Janny. Oh, the Janny, aye, the Janny. Who nearly drove me mad. Who shot me to the teachers any time that I was bad. I'm glad he's no retired or deed or living in Gamgad. A poor wee soul was the Janny. There was a wrestler, and he was a Russian, and he was called Ivan the Terrible. And everybody was terrified of him, because he had two famous holds, the half pretzel and the full pretzel. The half pretzel broke your back, and the full pretzel killed you. So there was this trail of dead bodies all over Russia, and until nobody would fight him anymore, and he said, oh, wait a minute. However they say that in Russian. And he joined a circus. £1,000 to anyone who'll last one round with the dreaded Ivan the Terrible. No takers. They're all going, oh, quake, quake in the seat. Circus goes right across Europe. Oh, I'm no fighting that. And then one day the circus came to Glasgow. They set up the tent in Glasgow Green. £1,000 to any man who last one round. I'll do it! Do you know what you're doing, sir? Aye! Who are you going to fight? I don't care!
Give some money to New and see if he's out of trouble. Ivan the Terrible from the steps. Never been beaten. Too famous. I don't care. Down the aisle. The crowd are chanting.
Easy, easy. Into him, into him. Gone shuggy. We are the champions.
Easy, boys. It's all right. It's a dado. He's out there. About 3'4" with the glasses on. The big heavy boots with the steel toe caps. Ach, it's a dado. Where is he anyway, this bamstick? The block says, well, be it on your own head, sir. Give us Ivan the Terrible. So they let him out his net and shove him through the curtains. It's all hair and teeth. The block goes, oh, wait a minute. Is that it? Guy says, aye, he says, all right, come on, well. Shut your mouth. The boot right in the crutch, down he went, squealing like a pig. Oh, shut up. The crowd are gone mad. Into him, into him, easy. Any bother, wallop. Ivan's rolling about, squealing like a pig. He's just about to lapse into unconsciousness and he grabs a wee shuggy's leg. Go to, wait a minute. He starts to climb up. One arm over. Oh, says the crowd. The half pretzel. Another arm over. Oh, no. The full pretzel. The two of them fall to the floor. They're in a knot, in a big ball. They're rolling about. You can hear. Oh, no. And then, bang. Ivan comes spinning off, hits the wall, slides down, unconscious. Crowd are going crazy. Hello! We are the champion! And the wee fella's getting interviewed. Tell me, Mr. Shug. He says, you did... you did really desperately well there. Could you tell the crowd and myself how you managed it? He said, ach, I wish I thought, I don't know what I mean. He said, he just got a hunger in that one pretzel thing. I fell in the flare, no, and we were in a big knot in that, know what I mean? All of a sudden, I feel the life draining right out of me. And I sees it right in front of me. A huge wally. I goes like that, oh, wait a minute. What's the day I sinks my teeth right into it? And you know something? It's amazing the surge of strength you get when you bite your own willy, right? A cracker, isn't it? Thank you.
having a party. It was Christmas, and she invited all the staff for the palace. Because she's nice that way, you know. She even went out and got the carry out herself. She was seen sneaking through the St. James's Park with an Agnew's bag. But this... She's had a big party, and she's got all the staff in. And they're all having a right good time. They're all getting tore into the magic. Yeah, well, I here's to you, any bother home. And she was sitting, singing Old Scotch Mother Mine in the corner. Next to her was the butler. And next to the butler is Prince Philip. Next to Prince Philip's a wee chambermaid. And she's making a right ass of herself, you know. She's laughing at her. You stole my... And the Queen says, excuse me, dear, are you feeling hysterical? She says, no, he's feeling mine. Before I put my banjo down, I'd like to play a wee tune. It's called Leather Breeches. Go back to school for a minute, because school meant quite a lot to me. As I told you earlier, I didn't like it an awful lot, bordering on hatred for the whole affair. But I remember the traumatic experience when I left primary school to go to secondary school and discovering to my horror that almost everybody in secondary school had dry noses. Couldn't believe it. I was used to this green ice rink. There was all different kinds of snottery people. Some had the traditional number 11 on the upper lip. And no matter how they rubbed and blew and scrubbed at it with hankies, it was always... Even when there was a heat wave and it dried up, there was two wee valleys where it should be. Other guys were continually searching for them. Ramming the fingy up the nostril.
Nothing.
What's that?
Nothing. I'll try up here and in the corner a bit.
Nothing. But there was one guy infuriated me completely. He was behind me somewhere. I never found out yet who he was. He used to go... Who's doing that noise? Was that you that's doing that? This guy stood up. He says, no, Billy, it wasn't me. I'm the farter. It was somebody over there. I should have known better. I idolised this guy. What a talent. How I envied him. He could fart at will. What a talent. I used to say, "Dare a fart. Dare another fart. Dare two farts, one after the other. What a talent he had. He could do all different kinds. And there was ones that he reserved for parties. But his pièce de résistance, his biggie, he could fart in stereo! A genius he was. I used to practice just trying to be like him, hoping I would someday be able to do at least one at will. I used to go nothing, not as much as a you know, it's amazing the things you do when you're at school, isn't it? Did you ever pee yourself in the class? I did it twice, as far as I remember. I did it several times, only twice in the class. I'll never forget it. Wriggling about in your seat. Miss, 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 miss. Trying to catch her eye and she's purposely avoiding you. Miss, 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 miss. Connolly, will you be quiet? Can't you see I'm trying to teach the rest of the class? I'm just, miss, miss. Miss! What is it? I say, oh, forget it. Steam. Get his sister! My sister was older than me. She had to come down and take me away home. Hanging onto the shorts, pulling them out for your legs as you're walking. Trying to keep the flannels off the thighs. The legs are scattered. And then one day, one day, I went over the top completely. I shit myself! Right there in the class. And they were singing a hymn when I did it. As far as I can remember, they were singing hymns most of the time anyway. But they were all sitting singing. Spring flowers of the fairest, spring flowers of the fairest, from God, from God. Who's that? I'm sitting, fanning myself with two slices of toast. Poor sister had to come down and take me home again. The stiff-legged walk. Trying to walk without moving your legs. Oh, those wee horrible guys in the street. You check your trousers. You're walking like that and saying, no, I didn't! And you're thinking of the baiting you're going to get when you get home. Oh, no! You're at the door and your mother comes to the door. What happened? A big boy did it and ran away! Liar! Wumph! Ha
She stood on the bridge in the pale moonlight like a veritable goddess, except for the snorter on her upper lip and the hole in her liberty bodice. Right.
Never gonna see your daddy's loving smile. Don't say, oh no. When the sun comes up, I'll be walking out the door. You're never gonna see your baby anymore. Don't say, oh no. When the sun comes up, I'll be leaving. I don't give a damn if your heart's grieving. I'm following the things I believe in. Don't say, oh no. You can have the cabin and I'll have the world. Don't say, oh no. When the sun comes up, I'll be leaving. I don't give a damn if the heart's grieving. I'm following the things I believe in. Don't say, oh no. For a while, you're never gonna see your daddy's loving smile. Don't say, oh no. When the sun comes up, I'll be walking out the door. You're never gonna see your baby anymore. Don't say, oh no. When the sun comes up, I'll be leaving. I don't give a damn if your heart's grieving. I'm following the things I believe in. Don't say, oh no. Thank you.